Hey YouTube, it's iPhone Mastermind, and today I'm going to be showing you the main features of the new iOS 5. So, features I'll be showing you today are Notification Center, iMessage, Camera Enhancements, Photo Editing, Twitter Integration, Reminders, Newsstand, and Safari Enhancements. And if you're looking for a different video, such as iOS 5 Hidden Features or iCloud, if you go ahead and click on those buttons, they'll link you to those videos. And also, if you want to skip to a certain feature, go ahead and click on that feature right now, and you'll be skipped to that feature in the video. The first feature I'm going to be showing you guys is the new Notification Center. So before iOS 5, when you got a notification, an alert would pop up on the screen, basically notifying you of your notification. However, it would interrupt whatever you're doing. So Apple took a new approach on this and made Notification Center. So I'm just going to send myself a text, and you'll see how you now get notifications. As you can see, when I got that notification, a little scroll bar simply came from the top of the screen. And if you don't touch it or do nothing with it, it simply scrolls back into it. So this time I'm going to tap on it so you can see what happens when you do that. If you tap on it, it goes to the corresponding application of that notification. Also, if you scroll down from the status bar, no matter in what application you're in, landscape, portrait, whatever, it will bring up your notification center. And here you can see the weather, the stocks, and you can disable the weather and or the stocks. And if you have any unread notifications, they'll show up here. But as you can see, I have no new notifications, so there's nothing here. So that's the new Notification Center. It's pretty cool. And you can also go into settings and now edit the notifications settings a lot more. So for example, weather widget, I'm going to turn that off and keep the stocks there, even though usually you do vice versa. And say for the messages, I don't want any kind of notification. I can select none, or I can select alerts, meaning the old pop-up kind of thing. And they have those for like timers and stuff and alarms. But I'm just going to keep it on that. And you can also change stuff such as how many you want it to show in Notification Center if you have that many missed notifications for that application. Badge app icon for the lock screen. If you want to show a preview on the lock screen. If you want to repeat the alert. And if you want it to be able to view in the lock screen. So I'm just going to show you real quick what it means by all those new options. So there you can see I just got a notification and now it's in the lock screen. And I can either slide to reply down here or I can slide the application's icon. And that's cool if you have multiple notifications. You can simply slide the notification you want to look at's icon and it'll pop up. So that's what it was talking about when it was talking about badge apps and show preview and stuff like that. So that's the Notification Center and the Notification Center settings. And now we're going to move on to iMessage. This next feature I'm going to show you guys is called iMessage. iMessage is a play on words text messaging service for iPod touches, iPhones, and iPads. So basically you can text an iPhone or iPad from an iPod touch and vice versa for iPhones and iPads. So I'm going to send a text message from my iPod touch to my iPhone. So once you go into the messages application first, then it will ask you to set up your account, so go ahead and do that, and then you can receive and send text messages from that email address. So I'm sending a text message to iPhoneMastermind2@gmail.com, which is the email I have set up on this phone along with my phone number. I'm going to text it test. Alright, there I received it. Took a little bit longer than it usually does. And I'm obviously going to reply, test. Usually it's pretty instant because it does run over Wi-Fi/3G. So it's faster than usual text messages. And what's cool is it's kind of like an IMing service is when someone else is typing on the other end. It shows you with these little dots. I'm just going to erase everything, get rid of those dots. There's also this thing called red receipts. I'm going to show you what it is right now. So I'm going to type in test again, send it to my iPod touch. And there you can see it says red 5:36 p.m. So I'm just gonna lock my iPod Touch, say that whoever has this iPod isn't really paying attention right now, isn't there. And I'm gonna say, hey. So there you can see it says delivered. However, if they're not using the iPod, it's just gonna stay in the lock screen. So they actually haven't read it yet. But if I slide to reply, basically open it, it's gonna show that they just read it. So there you can see it says red 5:36, and you can enable this or disable this in the settings application. So if you're trying to ignore somebody, it's not gonna work if you have red receipts on. And also for the iPhone, there's some other settings such as send as SMS, send it as SMS when iMessage is unavailable, basically meaning if you don't have Wi-Fi or 3G, but if you have carrier. And also there's just some other plain things there. And for the iPhone, it is the Messages application plus iMessage into one. So that's iMessage available on the iPod Touch, iPad, and iPhone. The next few features I'm going to show you guys are camera improvements. So the first one is you can now access the camera from double tapping the home button on the lock screen and then tapping this little camera icon. It does open up faster actually, and you can now also pinch to zoom. Usually you'd have to use this little scroll bar down here. You can now turn on a grid to focus or to center or off-center something. And you can also now lock auto exposure and autofocus. So if you're trying to take a picture of something and it keeps autofocusing or auto exposuring itself to something, then you can lock it, or if you're taking a video, for example. And you can also now take a picture by just tapping the plus volume up button on your device. So those are the new camera improvements. And while I'm here, I'm going to show you the new photo editing they added with iOS 5. So here you can see I'm in that picture I just took. And now there's this new button up here that says edit. So I'm going to tap edit. You can rotate it. I'm going to rotate it to there. You can auto enhance it. This is really good for when you're taking pictures of people with lots of different background brightnesses or colors. So it auto enhanced it, even though you can't really tell. It's better with people, like I said, or something else. You can fix red eye, which there is none, obviously, so I'm not going to be able to do that. And you can crop. So, okay, not that. All right, crop. And you can, there you go. So I just rotated it and cropped it, and you can tap save. And there you go. So those are the new camera improvements and photo editing they have in iOS 5. In iOS 5, they also brought new Twitter integration right into the iOS. So I'm just going to show you two examples right here. I'm going to tweet a photo by going to the Photos application, tapping this icon right down here, tweet, and there you can see the picture is attached, and I can add my location or add a caption. And down here you can see they have built-in mention and hashtag symbols. And I'm just going to go into Safari now, tap that same button, tweet, and now the web page link is attached, and I can also do captions, locations, and all that other cool stuff. Those are just two examples. There are some other ways built into the iOS and other applications, but that's Twitter integration. However, you will need to set up your Twitter account in the settings application and then in Twitter before you do it. In iOS 5, they also added a new application called the Reminders application. So if you go on into that, you can already see I have a few reminders set up for my schoolwork. And you simply tap the little plus button, type something in. And then once you can actually edit some things in it, such as remind me on a day, you can have it remind you on a day, or if you have a 3G device at a location, so when you leave or arrive at a location, it will give you a notification. And you can also change the priority or notes for it. And it's a really simple application, simply for reminders. So that's pretty cool. It's available on all three devices. And now on to Newsstand. Newsstand now allows you to be able to download magazines onto your iDevice and read them on your iDevice. And when new issues come out, it'll actually give you push notifications. So as you can see, I already have one push notification, meaning one of my magazines has a new issue out. So I'm just going to go to store before I do anything. And you can buy free magazine issues or you can buy them. However, I give you guys caution because most of these that say free, it's not really free. Just downloading the application is free. It may give you about one free issue, but the rest of them you have to buy. And here you can see iNet is free, and I'll go into that later and show you how it's not free. But basically, you download them here. Some are free, some give you free issues, some don't. Just gotta look into that a little bit. So I'm going to go into the iNet, like I just showed you. And here you can see I can buy the November 2011 edition for $7. There's the October. And here's the one that I was talking about. Here's the free edition. As you can see, it says how it'll give you this one for free. So I already downloaded it. I'm just going to tap read. And I can tap index to go to something else. But I'm just going to read through it. So you can double tap, you know, scroll, zoom. Pretty cool. It works really good on the iPad. The iPod Touch and iPhone, kind of iffy to read magazines on. But the iPad is great. I've already tried it and it works wonderful. So I'm just scrolling through this magazine. So this is the free version, and like I said, you can buy other versions, but this is basically the one app. And what's different about Newsstand that I wasn't expecting is every magazine developer provides their own version of their own app. So as you can see, this one's in its own format. And if I go to this one, it's going to be a whole different format. So here you can see different tabs. It's obviously different on the iPad. Different developers don't even have some of these tabs. It's just very different. So some are free, some aren't. You get the point. Newsstand, magazines, pretty cool. And now I'm going to show you guys Safari enhancements from iOS 5. Alright, so I'm going to show you guys three Safari enhancements that come with iOS 5. And the first two I'm going to show you are available on all three devices. However, the last one, which is only available for the iPad. So the first one I'm going to show you is called Reading List. So basically, Reading List allows you to be able to set up a list of articles you want to read later. So let's say I want to read this article about Lindsay Lohan later. I can go ahead and tap the button right here, Add to Reading List. And then if I go into my bookmarks, Reading List, it'll be there for later reading. Or if I want to just check it out later, basically it's a read later kind of list. So I'm going to delete that. That's available on all three devices. And then this next feature I'm going to show you is called Reader. So as you can see, I want to read about Lindsay Lohan. Well, not really, but if I wanted to. You can see there's all these ads and this clutter on the top. I just want to read the actual article. I don't care about any of this other stuff. So at the top, in the address bar, there's this new button that says Reader. And if I tap Reader, it gets rid of all the clutter and leaves only the pictures to the article and the actual article. It's available on all three devices, and it helps very much when you're trying to read news on mobile news websites or just any kind of articles, really. So I'm going to turn that off. And this last feature I'm going to show you is only available on the iPad because it has a bigger screen. So basically, it's tabs just like on computer internet browsers. So I can switch quickly from Lindsay Lohan to Apple or just whatever. So here you can see I just got all these different tabs. You can move them around. You can exit out of them. I'm gonna exit out of this new tab. It's very cool. It makes it seem very more interactive. And Safari on the iPad has really gotten better with new tab browsing. And obviously with these other features, it makes everything just so much more simple and easier.
Thanks for watching my video, guys. Don't forget to like this video up and subscribe for more app reviews, tweak reviews, Apple news, and more. And also, if you want to go ahead and check out some other videos like this, go ahead and click on the buttons to those videos, such as iOS 5 hidden features, which are some other features that came with iOS 5, but aren't as big, but are still pretty cool, and iCloud, the service which allows you to wirelessly sync so many different things between iPod Touches, iPads, iPhones, and Macintoshes. And go and click on the button to the right to subscribe. Thanks for watching my video, guys. I hope you all enjoyed it. And I'll see you all later.